No time to lose today, because this lecture is about key performance indicators. Let's start. If you haven't heard about it before, get used to it. KPI. KPI is an acronym for key performance indicator. A KPI is supposed to accurately measure the performance areas that are most critical to your organization's success. The word key means that you are not supposed to have many of them. Maybe a number between 1 and 10 is reasonable. The fewer the better though, as long as the indicators can capture the essential information for controlling and managing a process or a business. Let me give you some common examples to start with. Inventory turnover. It cannot be measured directly, but it is calculated by dividing the total number of sold products with the average inventory level. This performance indicator says something about how fast a firm is able to turn its stocks, hence also the speed of cash flow and related risks of carrying inventory. Another common example is productivity, which is sometimes calculated as number of units produced per hours of labor used. Other typical examples include product defects or customer complaints, which are both usually measured as a rate of defects or complaints over total number of products produced or sold. Then a last example is OEE, overall equipment efficiency, which is a measure of how efficiently machines are utilized in manufacturing. This measure is particularly important in make-to-stock environments or when machines are bottlenecks or very expensive. A company can have hundreds of such performance indicators, but not all of them should be key. Finally, there are all kinds of parameters that can be measured directly. They include, for example, timestamps, counted units, pressure, energy consumption, cost, and so on. Indicators are typically calculated from several of these measured parameters. So now, the challenge for companies is to pick the right performance indicators, prioritize them according to business objectives, measure them properly, and create systems and routines for acting on them. And note, this should be done for each department and unit, and routinely revised when things change. Let me give you an example. Let's visit a paint factory again. What key performance indicators do you think this factory should track? Ah, look at the wall over there. That looks like a visual performance board meant to create attention to the most important metrics. This factory seems to have three particularly important performance indicators. The upper chart reports productivity, measured in liter of paints per labor hour. The middle chart reports on time in full, which indicates how many customer deliveries are complete and on time. And the lower chart is a health and safety metric. It measures the number of near misses. That is, how many times something almost went wrong, which operators are asked to report. And look over there. That is a board collecting the key performance indicators of the whole factory. I can see that they measure, for example, average batch lead time, right first time, that is how many samples were accepted first time in quality control, the throughput times in quality control, returns from customers, utilizations of technicians, planned, produced, and realized volumes for each production line, and the OEE for each line. We can also see that these numbers are manually written on a whiteboard for a daily status meeting. So this factory is clearly using the performance measures to follow up and managing performance on a daily basis. This is the same for many manufacturers in competitive industries. KPIs are used to track, but they are meaningless without the target measure. So what makes a good KPI target? Actually, one that is smart. Smart goals are specific, measurable, attainable, relevant, and time-bound. There's another essential insight regarding measurement you need to be aware of. There is an important difference between lead and lag metrics. Lead indicators are performance drivers, and lag metrics are outcome measures. Consider, for example, a person who wants to lose some weight after a holiday season. It is much more effective for this person to measure intake calories and physical activity, such as steps per day, than to repeatedly measure body weight. The closer you move to measuring process inputs and activities, the closer you get to leading indicators. If you are measuring aggregated results at an organizational level, you are more likely using lagging indicators. The key to picking good leading measures is to deeply understand the process that leads to the outcome we ultimately want. Picking the right indicators is not easy and a subject of continuous discussion and revision in firms. Having good performance indicators help a firm progress faster towards its goals. Having the wrong ones can ruin a performance culture and be detrimental to overall performance. In this lecture, we covered the role of key performance indicators, how to set smart performance goals, and the difference between lead and lag indicators.